next song called Gethsemane. It talks about the time that Christ spent in the Garden of Gethsemane just before going to the cross. And I can think of three times in the Bible that it tells us that, you know, stories in Christ's ministry, that Satan was probably the closest to trying to thwart and work the hardest to try and thwart Christ's mission on earth. The first I can think of it probably in the temptation in the wilderness when Christ went in for 40 days. And the Bible says he went into the wilderness to be tempted. But was able to meet Satan's assaults and temptations with Scripture. And the same resource that we have, he didn't use his divinity to overcome Satan. And that's encouraging to us. But the second was here in the Garden of Gethsemane, and the third certainly on the cross. But this song talks about the time he spent in prayer there, pleading with his Father, if there was any other way that salvation could be accomplished for humanity. If that could come about, he would be fine with that, but nevertheless, he submitted to God's will. So in this song, you hear the questioning, the pleading, the anguish, and really the conflict. Partway through the song, you'll hear the bells that are played into the table. It's called the martellato technique, which is the Italian word based on when we get hammered. And they're pounded into the table, signifying the nails that would pierce Christ's hands, the two in the hands and one through the feet. So listen for that. Throughout the whole song, there are hints and glimpses of the chorale, O Sacred Head Now Wounded. And if you're really a student listening, you'll hear that in the beginning and throughout. But at the end, it comes through in a beautiful way with the chimes being played along, mixed in with the bells and the suspended balance on the high end. So if you could think about those ideas and thoughts as we play Gethsemane.